Greetings, Matalino. Again, I am Junvert. In this video, let us discuss three different solutions for finding the reactions at A and B for this structure with five members. Our first solution is the component method, wherein we are going to resolve all forces into X and Y components. The second method is without the use of components for the given load. Instead, we are going to find the moment arm of the given force relative to our moment center. In our third method, we are going to use the fundamental principle of statics for non-parallel forces in equilibrium. Let us begin with the directions of our reaction forces. At A, the horizontal reaction must be to the left. It will resist the horizontal component of this 20 kN force, which is to the right. Okay? Because of this force, the tendency of this structure will rotate clockwise about point B. That's why the reaction here at A, the vertical reaction here at A, must be downward to prevent that rotation. Okay? Then, this force also has a tendency to compress this point B towards the ground. So, the reaction at B must be upward. Okay? If you made a mistake of finding these directions, don't worry. You will get the same answer, the same magnitude, but of opposite sign. Use the absolute value to get the correct answer. Next, we are going to resolve this 20 kN force into components. These are the components of our force. For this horizontal component, we have this 20 cosine of 30. For this vertical component, that is opposite of 30 degrees, this line here is equal to this line. So that is 20 sine of 30. Summation of moment at A equal to 0. Counterclockwise moment, we have this RB. Moment arm is 9. 9 times RB is equal to, there is no other counterclockwise moment about point A. Let us equate this one to clockwise moments about point A. We have this 20 cosine of 30, this force. The moment arm of that is from this line of action perpendicular to the moment center, and that is equal to 4.5. Okay? How about this 20 sine 30? This will also rotate clockwise about point A. Okay? The moment arm is 12. Solve for RB. We have this answer. 21.99 kilonewton. Next, summation of forces in the x direction. To the left, which is AH, is equal to the right. 20 cosine of 30. And we have the value of AH. How about summation of forces in the y direction? Zero. We have upward or downward is equal to upwards. We have downward AV plus 20 sine of 30 is equal to upward RB, 21.99. We have the value of AV. Why we use different color for this and we put it in a box? What's so special for this solution? Actually, this solution is not recommended. The reason, we use here the value of RB, which is a derived value. As much as possible, do not use a derived value like this one in your equation. Because if your derived value is wrong, it will follow that your next solution is also wrong. If we can find a way of solving AV without the use of this RB, this derived value, then it is a better solution. This is not a hard rule, but that is highly recommended. It is safer that way. So, how to do that? What equation we are going to use so that it will not involve the value of RB? What do you think? You are correct. We are going to use the summation of moment. But at what point? Of course, so that it will not involve the value of RB and the value of AH, we are going to sum up moments at their point of intersection. So the point of intersection of this AH and this RB is this point. Let us call this point the point A. Alright? Now if you are going to sum up moments about this point, it will only involve the unknown AV. Summation of moment at A0. counterclockwise moment, 9 AV, is equal to clockwise moments. Clockwise moments, we have this 20 cosine 30, the moment arm is 4.5 again, and 20 sine 30, the moment arm is 3 meters. Solve for AV. In this way, we did not use any of the derived value, and these are our answers. Of course, our answer is not yet complete. We need to determine the direction of the total reaction at A. Let us call that theta x, and the tangent of that is equal to A vertical all over A horizontal. Can you recall why our formula is this one? So if I may write here a triangle for our force, if this is the force F, this is the theta x, this is the Fy, and this is the Fx. Alright? That's why the tangent of our angle theta, if we measure that from x, is always Fy all over Fx. Alright? Okay? So that is why we have this vertical over horizontal. Substitute this AV and AH in our equation, and our tangent of that quotient, we have this value of theta x. And we are going to find the total reaction here at A. The total reaction is by Pythagorean theorem. Okay? If you see this triangle again, we have horizontal squared plus vertical squared. So we have this equation, horizontal squared plus vertical squared at A. And substitute these two values, we have the value of RA. And that is our solution. I think many of you are interested only up to this point. Okay? You are not interested to another solution because this is the required solution our professors demand from us. And this is very powerful solution. Okay? Do not underestimate this approach because this is the highly recommended solution for attacking problems like this. If you are that person that is interested only up to this point, you are dismissed. Okay? For those who are interested on another approach, just continue watching. In our next solution, we are not going to resolve this 20 kilonewton force into components. This is the line of action of the 20 kilonewton force. And to find the value of RB, we are going to sum up moments at point A. So to do that, let us find this moment arm. Okay? If we can find this value of D, then we can find the value of RB. How to find the moment arm D in meters? We have these dimensions. This is 12 meters and 4.5 meters. Take note that this is horizontal and this is vertical, meaning they are perpendicular to each other. If you are going to connect A and C like this one, we just created a right triangle. Okay? We can find the value of D if we can find this angle. Okay? This angle, of course, is arctangent of 4.5 all over 12. Use your calculator to solve this one. Note that this angle here is also equal to this angle above. Okay? They are equal. Then, what is this angle? Of course, this is 30 degrees plus this angle, which is 20.56. So we have this 50.56 degrees from this line of action of our 20 kilonewton force. Now we have this right triangle with this green line, the hypotenuse. And this hypotenuse is common hypotenuse for this triangle also. So what is the length of this AC? Pythagorean theorem, that is the square root of 12 squared plus 4.5 squared. This is the length. Now, what is the value of D? This value of D is sine opposite over the hypotenuse. This is equal to 12.82 sine of 50.56. 9.897 meters. Alright. Now, we have this moment arm. We can now solve for the reaction at B. Summation of moment at A, 0. Counterclockwise, 9 times RB. Clockwise rotation, 20 kilonewton times this moment arm. 20 times 9.897 meters. This is the answer for RB. Did we really improve with this solution? In comparison with our previous solution, we only replace this value here, this line here, with this line. You may say that this solution is more convenient than this previous solution. Actually, in most cases, the previous solution is more convenient compared to this one. This solution did not involve those complexities of finding the angles and this moment arm. In most cases, the given figure is sufficient to solve the problem. You don't need to find any distances or any angles. Alright? Personally, I still prefer this solution. And you will see it in more complicated situations where this solution is more appropriate than this one. Alright? But for the sake of discussion for the second method, let us continue using this approach. Now, how to find the horizontal reaction and the vertical reaction at A? For the horizontal reaction, we are going to use summation of forces in the x direction 0, the same solution in our first approach. Alright? How about the A vertical? For the A vertical, remember, we sum up moments at point E, the intersection of this AH and RB. So we are going to sum up moments here, but we are not going to use the components of this 20. That is the purpose of this presentation. We are not going to resolve this into components. Meaning, we are going to find the moment arm of this 20 kN force with respect to this moment center. So what is the distance from this point perpendicular to this line of action of our 20 kN force? I am talking about this line. Alright? So if we can find the length of this line, we can proceed with our solution. Okay? How to find this length? Let us erect a line that is parallel to 20 kN that will pass through point E. This is the line. And of course, this is 30 degrees. If we can find this length, that green line, we can also find this length. Okay. What is this length? This is 9 meters, hypotenuse of the triangle, because this is 90 degrees here. This is 90 degrees here because this line is parallel to this 20 kN force, perpendicular here, meaning perpendicular here. Of course, that is sine opposite over the hypotenuse. So this length is equal to 9 sine of 30 degrees. That is actually 4.5 meters. So 9.897 minus 4.5, that will become 5.397 meters. Summation of moment at point E, 0. Alright? We have this counterclockwise moment, that is AV times 9. Is equal to clockwise moment, 20 times this moment arm, 5.397. Solve for AV. We have the answer of AV. Okay? Again, in comparison with our previous solution, this part here is replaced by these two numbers. Which is more convenient? This second solution or this first solution? Personally, I still prefer the first solution. More powerful than this one. Alright? Although this second solution showcase our ability in trigonometry and in geometry, it will not make this approach more powerful than the previous solution. Alright? And again, for this second approach, which we use a lot of trigonometry and geometry, another disadvantage of this approach is that it seems there are infinite number of ways we can deal with this problem. Not like in this component method that we will only think in a certain way. It looks like a reverse intuition, but actually that is more appropriate when it comes to mechanics. If you have a consistent approach in attacking any type of problem, that will be good. Imagine, for this problem only, if you are going to use geometry or trigonometry, there are many ways to attack this problem. You may do it this way. It seems there are infinite number of ways to deal with the problem. Can you see that? You can solve for X and Y before you can solve for D. Or you are going to deal it like this one. We acknowledge that these four points form a cyclic quadrilateral because this angle here and this angle here are both 90, so the sum here is 180 degrees. It will follow that the sum here is also 180 degrees. You can think it this way. Okay? Sir, that is more elegant compared to one solution only. It is not when it comes to mechanics. If we have a consistent solution and we are going to master that, then it will be more than enough to solve any complicated situation in statics. Alright? From time to time, we are going to use the geometry solution. But this is not our focus. Our focus here is the component method. Alright, let us go back to our problem. And we already have this value of AH and AV. So we can proceed with finding the direction of RA and its magnitude. Okay? For our last solution, we are going to use one of the fundamental principle of mechanics. What is that principle? Take note that we only have three forces here. The reaction at B, the reaction at A, the total reaction here, and this given load. I already mentioned this principle in my previous video. The link is given above. Just click that link if you want to watch that video. Now, what is that principle? If we have three non-parallel forces in equilibrium, I will repeat, if we have three non-parallel forces in equilibrium, they are always concurrent. They will always meet at one point only. This force and this force, it is clear, they will meet at this point. Okay? But how about the reaction here, the total reaction here? According to our principle, these three forces are concurrent, meaning the line of action of the reaction at A will also pass at this point. This is the line of action of the reaction at A, and this is our reaction at A. All right? How to solve for RA and RB? Let us find this angle. What is this angle? Let us call this angle theta. We can solve for this theta if we can find this height. We call this height y. Alright. Now, take note that this is 30 degrees angle here. Okay? Y is equal to what? This is 3 meters. So, tangent of 30 degrees is opposite. Y over the adjacent. Therefore, y is equal to what? 3 meters tangent of 30. We have this value of y. We can now find the value of theta. And that is arctangent of what? Opposite. 4.5 plus y. Okay? All over the adjacent. 9 meters. Okay? Substitute the value of y here. 3 tangent 30 degrees. You can solve the value of theta. With all directions known, the reaction at A, the direction is known. The RB, the direction is known, of course, from the start. And this given direction of 20 kN force, with all directions known, we can now solve for RA and RB. Yeah. I will leave to you how to do that. Yeah. Okay? That is for concurrent forces in equilibrium. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. And see you in our next video. Bye-bye!